Welcome back everyone, this is Aki Magneto. Now we are on the next step to create a connection file. Connection file is the most essential file you can ever create in this tutorial. Why is it essential? Three things. The first thing is that your database you already created is in a remote area and it serves as your storage area. Now you need a file to make sure that this client side being scripted by HTML, CSS or the Bootstrap, so to speak, will have a link with that remote server. So now what we need to do right now is to create our connection file. And please, there are different types of variables that you can use, but I have my own that I normally use. Now we need to create a file, and I want to save that. I'm gonna name it connection.php. Now once you do that, that means you already save it. Please make sure you don't save it inside the folder, save it inside the root of the folder you already have there. Now the first thing to start PHP is to, this is the syntax for writing PHP. Yeah, now the next thing you're gonna do is just to db con, sorry, this is my variable for now. I'm going to write some MySQL commands. So if you want to learn more about MySQL commands and stuff, you can go straight to w3schools.com. you would see more and more and more of that. So let's move db con. It's equals to MySQL connect. You already have it there. Now there's a parenthesis that will be open where you need to, sorry, we need two more of this, a comma, this, sorry, this, a comma, this, and a semicolon after it. Now we're going to use a local host here. Now I'm going to use a root. Now you leave the password. This is the root. This is the password. This is username. This is the host. This is the password. Now, if you want to edit your password, that means you need to edit your root folder for your server. Now the next one we're going to do right here is to run another MySQL select database. MySQL select. Sorry, I'm in need of E, so that's why I kept the copy here. Select DB. Now this is the beacon. Now we are going to insert our the name of the database we created before. I think it's let's check for our database that we already created before. Database, it's the database is lame. Okay, lame. Okay, now it is lame. Now let's put it here. Now once you attribute this, you can check again. Please kindly make sure what you type here is correct. Any incorrect letter here or alphabet, sorry, a semicolon after this, you can see these are where programmers make costly errors which can cause hour of debugging. So once you're through with this, we are trying to create a connection. Now we're going to move to the next video where you learn how to where we do the major work, where we make our register.php file work. I mean this, where we make this work. So we are going to collect data. Now let's kindly do some correlations to what we have in our database alongside our registration form. Now, if you look through this place where you can enter any text you want here, you will see it's going to be stored inside the name and this username. That means you can use Douglas 09. That means it's going to be stored inside the username. And the third one is the email address. You can say gijoe@gmail.com. It's going to be stored inside the user email. Now, the next one is the password. You know, it's going to be hidden feed. So you can enter as more as possible. Depends on the number of lengths allowed in this. Now, once you submit the query, that means once you click on submit, its function is to first make sure that you are not registered before. Then, if you're registered before, it saves the data inside this place. So, whenever you want to check, maybe someone has registered on your website, you can just click on browse. But for now, there is no result there. That's why I say MySQL return an empty result set. Now, kindly let me show you something here. Please, whenever you are working on a PHP script, it's very volatile. So you have to be very careful with the way you handle your code, your tags, everything. Make sure you go through them over and over. Even during the course of this video, I might make some mistakes that you might see. No one is above perfection. We're still under the procedure of learning. So now I'll meet you in the next video where we go straight to registration.php file. Thank you. And if you have any comments, or if by any way you make a mistake, please try to pause the video, go back, switch back, and check where you might have made an error or not. And if by the end of the day you are not getting the same result as mine, kindly comment underneath this video right now, and I'll attend to you immediately. Thanks so much. This is Aki Magneto. I'll meet you in the next video. Bye.